And welcome to This Is My Architecture. I'm really happy to be joined by Andrew from Finbourne today.
Hi, thanks for having me.
So Andrew, before we start with the whole use case, do you mind just explaining a little bit what Finbourne is doing nowadays?
Finbourne was founded in 2016 to lower the cost of investment and to improve transparency in the global investment community. Lucid, our product, powers business critical processes for companies like LSEG, Baillie Gifford, and Fidelity International.
So that means that Finbourne actually developed a new way to deliver data management. But I'm really thrilled to know, like, which one was the key driver that led you to implement chaos engineering?
Yeah, Finbourne follow ISO 22301, part of which is business continuity planning. Business continuity planning is about looking at what processes you have and what systems that you need to put in place to recover from failure.
And I can imagine that through the whole journey, you face a couple of challenges, right?
Yeah, absolutely. So we have sources of state and distributing those across different failure domains. Also being able to scale out in response to client utilization and keeping costs under control.
Amazing. So I see here that the architecture is separated in different layers. And I would love to know if you implemented chaos engineering on each one of the different layers. And if that's the case, how did you implement it?
Yeah, absolutely. So we receive about 10 million requests a day. We use Route 53 because it allows us to route to availability zones that are active at the moment. So if there's a failure in any one of those AZs, we're sort of routed away from it. We use NLBs because we want to route layer 4 traffic specifically.
Okay, so networking is already covered. What about the compute layer?
Yeah, so we use EKS. The benefit of EKS is that we can stripe our workloads across different failure domains, so across different instances or across different instance types, as well as across different AZs. We use EKS. Yes.
Amazing. So that means networking already checked, compute layer already checked, but for sure you're storing data somewhere, and that's the storage layer. Are you also covering that layer as well with chaos engineering?
Yeah, so we send data down to Aurora. We make about 3,000 requests a second. Aurora is really useful because it replicates across AZ and across regions with minimal lag. We run our Aurora instances on ARM to further improve the cost, and we fail them over routinely in order to be able to detect failures.
So the stats that you just mentioned are really huge and impressive. So now that you have everything already implemented, which one is the main benefit that you say, hey, we just really achieved this by implementing this use case?
The main benefit for us is improving resiliency. So we terminate an application every 17 minutes, we terminate an EC2 instance every 6 hours, and we fail an AZ twice weekly. With that, we get kind of improved availability as well. The other benefit is that we kind of keep cost in the best position we can.
Amazing. And you also mentioned about elasticity. And elasticity actually implies that the architecture and the different resources may grow, right? The whole infrastructure may grow. How is it actually that you keep a grip on the costs?
Yeah, so we use Karpenter, which is an open source autoscaler by AWS. The benefit of that is that we're able to provision on-demand as well as spot instances. Compared to running our on-demand clusters ourselves, spot saves us about 30% of the cost. And we chaos test this by terminating those spot instances kind of routinely.
Gotcha. So you covered a lot of different things here, but is there any specific thing that you would like to improve?
Yeah, so we'd like to route traffic to both regions simultaneously, so we're in an active-active situation. We would also like to introduce a service mesh so that we're able to be better resilient to failures within the cluster.
So that is what is coming on the future, right?
Mm.
So this is a lovely example that really showcases actually how you can deliver and implement resiliency in the financial and modern data stack. So Andrew, thanks a lot for guiding us through the whole architecture, and thanks a lot for your time as well.
Thank you for having me.
And thanks a lot for watching This Is My Architecture.